Children are continuing to die.
It is so scary.
Hidden hazards in your home. Tonight, a special report every parent or caregiver must see. Good afternoon, everyone. Imagine the horror walking in and finding your child hanging by the neck, strangled.
That's exactly what happened to a local woman's granddaughter, and this is no longer considered a freak accident as more and more children are choked to death by window blinds. Crystal Britt joins us live with tonight's special report. Crystal, this seems so hard to believe, but how often does it really happen?
More often than you might think. According to the group, Parents for Window Blind Safety, it's happening once, sometimes even twice a month in the U.S., and that's not even counting the cases that go unreported. When Linda Shaw of Poplar Bluff contacted us about her granddaughter's death, of course, we were all just simply blown away. And as a mother of a toddler, I wanted to know, how is this happening?
It was the most horrible thing.
3 months ago, Linda Shaw got the phone call that still haunts her.
They were on their way to the hospital, and she told me that there'd been a bad accident.
Her daughter, son-in-law, and grandchildren had just moved from Poplar Bluff to Birmingham, Alabama. They lived in a rental house where 15-month-old Autumn Schenck found a hidden danger.
Laura said, Mom, it's too late. She's gone. She climbed in the chair. She climbed up in the windowsill. And somehow she got that window blind.
She says it happened in an instant.
It's just a horrifying thought that that baby died like that.
The strangulation left so many unanswered questions.
I never thought those blinds would ever hurt anybody.
Linda Shaw quickly found her family isn't suffering alone. Linda Kaiser of Manchester knows the pain all too well. In June 2002, she lost her 12-month-old, Cheyenne.
I had placed her down for bed. I think it was about 7:30. Night when I checked on her, she was in the corner of her crib and in an unnatural position, and I knew something was wrong.
She says she tried CPR, but it was too late.
I didn't understand what had happened because my pull cords were tied up out of her reach, so I didn't understand how she got tangled up.
A few months after Cheyenne's death, Linda founded Parents for Window Blind Safety.
Children ages 10 years old and down have died. So it's not just the little bitty babies that don't know what they're doing. You know, we're talking 3, 4, 5, 6-year-olds up to 10.
She says her daughter strangled on the inner cord of a mini blind.
Somehow she got it around her neck.
Linda tells me other blinds have proved deadly, like the faux wood kind involved in Autumn Schenck's death. You can see the blinds in this picture of Autumn and her sister, taken not long before she died. There's also the cellular shade and Roman shades. Linda Kaiser calls these possibly the worst kind.
All a little boy or little girl needs to do is reach in here into the cords and pull on these and form a loop.
All you're doing
Dan Phillips owns Budget Blinds in Cape Girardeau.
It's really not on the consumer's mind. It's our job to make sure that they know that if they have children, we can provide them with safe products.
Since 2001, the government set safety standards.
They now add a small plastic bead to that cord, so therefore you cannot pull the cords through and children cannot get stuck in the cords.
Even Dan admits certain products don't belong in a child's home, like Roman shades.
Probably not the best choice for child safety.
While mini blinds are the cheapest option, more expensive cordless or remote controlled blinds are considered a better choice around children.
Anything that has no cords is obviously the safest way to go.
And that's what Linda Kaiser's been screaming about ever since her daughter died. But she tells me the Consumer Product Safety Commission just won't listen.
Nothing's being done about it. They won't recall them. They won't even tell the public not to use cords at all.
In the long run, that'd be great, but economically, it's probably not feasible at this point. You know, there's a lot of money that goes in, that's involved in that.
Money talks.
Linda Shaw says the window blind industry won't get another dime from her. After her granddaughter died, she ripped out every one in her home.
I cut them up so nobody else could use them.
And she's telling everyone she knows about the dangers while she grieves over Autumn, now buried just a few blocks from her home. She misses so much.
Her little hugs.
While her arms are empty, she's filled with a newfound passion.
People need to be aware that there is a danger there.
And she won't let anyone forget this child.
Her little life had to stand for something. It has to mean something.
Autumn's parents, Jim and Laura Shank, still live in Alabama. They're focusing right now on two things, taking care of their other daughter, two-year-old Willow, and suing the window blind industry. Jeff and Kathy.
But you know, I would have never thought when my daughter was little to worry about something
horrible.
Like that.
I just can't even imagine it. But it, you know, once you see the story, it makes sense. Those cords that you can just tell they're that dangerous when you look at them.
Right, and there's so much going on as far as the advocates, as far as their front is concerned. Mm-hmm. Of course, right now they're hoping for someday an all-out ban on window blind cords, period. And right now in the state of Missouri, Linda Kaiser tells me that they're working on trying to ban the cords in daycares. And apparently that's something that's already been done. A law has been enacted in the state of Washington after a child apparently died in a daycare there.
Well, you know there's tons of them out there still.
Mm-hmm. Yeah,
and it's good that we're getting the word out.